Good morning, children. Today I will discuss regarding the examples of moment of force. First example is, to open or shut a door, we apply a force normal to the door at its handle, which is provided at the maximum distance from the hinges. As I discussed last class, that we find easier to open a door if the force is applied at the extreme end from the hinges. It means we want to increase the perpendicular distance, and moment of force depends on force and the perpendicular distance. So if you're increasing the perpendicular distance, then the moment of force increases and we find easier to open the door. Similarly, the second example, the upper circular stone of a hand flour grinder is provided with a handle near its rim, because this way the perpendicular distance is maximum. If the hand flour grinder is provided with a handle near its rim, then the maximum is the perpendicular distance, so moment of force is more, and that's why we find easier to rotate. Another example is your wheel, your steering wheel. For turning a steering wheel, a force is applied tangentially on the rim of the wheel. In this way, the distance perpendicular, when the force F is applied at point A, see the diagram of the wheel, the perpendicular distance, if we take the wheel, means steering wheel bigger, diameter bigger, then perpendicular distance is more and we find easier to rotate either clockwise or anticlockwise. But if the steering wheel is smaller, then the diameter is less, and then perpendicular distance is also less and we find little difficult to rotate the wheel. In a bicycle, to turn the rear wheel anticlockwise, a small force is applied on the foot pedal of a toothed wheel of size bigger than the rear wheel, so that the perpendicular distance of the point of application of force is more. Here again the same reason, more is the perpendicular distance, more is the moment of force. Now, we'll discuss regarding the next example of moment of force. Spanner is the example of moment of force. See number 5. A spanner used to tighten or loosen a nut has a long handle to produce a large moment of force. Reasoning question comes, why a spanner has a long handle? Look at this diagram. I think all of you have seen. It is mainly used to loosen or tighten the nut of motorbike or scooter. You might have seen this. You see the length of this handle. The reason is, if the length of the handle is more, then the perpendicular distance is more. And again, the same point is applicable here. Moment of force equal to force into perpendicular distance. And as the handle is longer, so the perpendicular distance is more. And we can easily rotate it and the nut can be tighten or loosen easily, because moment of force will increase. Number 6. A jack screw used to lift a heavy load such as a vehicle has a long arm. Why? Question may come. Why?
You have to write because by applying less effort, we can lift it. Because as we know, moment of force equal to force into perpendicular distance. Long is the arm, more is the perpendicular distance, and moment of force increases. In that case, if you apply less effort, then only the purpose is served. So in spanner, long handle is used. In a screw jack, long arm is used. In flour grinder also, long arm is there. Everywhere in these cases, you can see we try to maintain the perpendicular distance more, which increases the moment of force. So you will remember these points by heart. Reasoning questions come from these points. Mainly spanner is important, and flour grinder is also important. So, but one point I give you, you just remember the formula for the moment of force. You will write moment of force equal to force into perpendicular distance. And if such kind of questions come, you will first write the formula. And then you will write if perpendicular distance is more, then moment of force increases. And by applying less effort, the work can be done easily. For every case, you will be writing this point only. Our topic is couple. See page 4. Couple is actually formed when two equal and opposite parallel forces, which are not acting along the same line. So, definition, if it comes, you will write two equal and opposite parallel forces not acting along the same line form a couple. In order to understand this topic, you need to concentrate in these examples. Have a look, all of you. Page 4, see the diagrams. Turning a water tap. You imagine you are opening or closing a water tap. What you do? You need to apply forces with the help of two fingers, thumb and the indicator. When you apply the forces, if you think minutely, then you see you are applying the forces in opposite directions. You move your fingers as you open your water tap, you see which directions you are applying the forces. In your thumb and indicator, you see equal and opposite forces are applied in opposite directions. Whenever such things happen, it forms a couple, and that's why a rotational motion is created there. Second example, opening or tightening the cap of a bottle. Here also, when you try to open or tighten the cap, there also we apply two equal and opposite forces. Please see the diagrams. Next one is turning a steering wheel. Right hand and left hand, see the positions. Right hand, if you are applying the force downward direction, left hand you have to apply the force upward direction, then only you will be able to rotate the steering wheel. It depends, you want to rotate it clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. If you are applying the force right hand clockwise direction, and see that this diagram, according to this diagram, downward means right hand force you are applying downward and left hand force you are applying upward, then it will be rotated clockwise direction. But if you are applying the force in your right hand upward and left hand downward, then you will be able to rotate it anti-clockwise direction. So all these four cases, you see two equal and opposite forces are being applied, but not along the same line. Now, if you want to find the moment of couple, then its measurement is moment of couple is equal to either force, means two forces you are applying, any measurement of any one of those forces into the distance between those two forces. In your diagram, page 5, you turn, see the distance AB AB is the distance between these two forces. So you have to know the distance AB and any one force, any one of these two forces, F. So the measurement is F into distance between these two forces, AB. Here also the unit is Newton meter applied, but not along the same line. Now, if you want to find the moment of couple, then its measurement is moment of couple is equal to either force, means two forces you are applying, any measurement of any one of those forces into the distance between those two forces. In your diagram, page 5, you turn, see the distance AB. AB is the distance between these two forces. So you have to know the distance AB and any one force, any one of these two forces, F. So the measurement is F into distance between these two forces, AB. Here also the unit is Newton meter.